Striking distance. This may look like a video game, but it's real and it's deadly. Individuals presumed to be terrorists are targeted from the air and destroyed. The aircraft that fired the missile flew thousands of feet overhead, but the person who pulled the trigger sat thousands of miles away in a military trailer like this one in Nevada. This is 21st century warfare, part of a revolution in robotic technology that's transforming the way we work, travel, heal, and fight. It's pilots like these, remotely controlling planes like these. The military calls them unmanned aerial vehicles. They're more commonly known as drones. Most drones are designed for spying rather than killing. They patrol skies that are too dangerous for planes with pilots on board. They track enemy movements from the air for hours. They scout locations before ground troops move in. These spies in the sky come in all shapes and sizes. There's the 3-foot-long Raven, which can fit in a soldier's backpack. There's the stealthy Sentinel, designed to be invisible to enemy radar. And there's the giant global Hawk, which can stay aloft for 35 hours at a time and survey up to 40,000 square miles a day. But the most famous drone is this one, the Predator. It weighs no more than a pickup truck and flies just 84 miles an hour. But the Predator, as you can guess from its name, is deadly. It carries a sensor ball with powerful cameras inside. From 5 miles high, it can differentiate targets from civilians, trace their movements, and direct laser-guided missiles to make precise strikes. The Predator has been so effective that the US military now trains more drone operators than actual pilots. And the skills they look for are the skills it takes to do this. Drone operation and video gaming are so similar that the military actively recruits gamers and trains them with video game controllers. That has some people worried about the future of war. Drones protect pilots by keeping them away from the battlefield. But when soldiers pull the trigger by remote control, an ocean away from the target, does killing become too easy? Too much like a video game? Some former drone operators say it's hard to have empathy for human life when the enemy is just a silhouette on a screen. But drones can also be used to save lives. In 2011, the Global Hawk helped survey damage after a devastating tidal wave in Japan. Much tinier drones may soon be able to scout a building for firefighters or help locate survivors in the wreckage of an earthquake. In the meantime, the military continues to develop new drone technology. From tiny surveillance robots to giant solar-powered spies that can stay airborne for years at a time.
We're gonna make more, we're gonna make them better, and we're gonna employ them more. I mean, that is the future.
And it is not a game.